Hey guys, this is Michael from OPEC, and I'm here at Metal Sucks. I'm gonna watch some YouTube videos of cover songs that I wrote. See how it sounds. Hopefully it sounds good. Here we go. He's good, that guy. We haven't really played this song ourselves that much yet, but I don't like when singers sing better than I do. This is the English version. I'm more used to the Swedish version myself. Ah, guys know what he's doing. Good singer. Good guitar player. Some incorrections in the chords, I think, but overall, impressive. With a drum machine. Alice in Chains t-shirt. My guitar, my signature model. I like it. Guy looks super relaxed as he's playing. Seems like this guy practiced a lot. So he's playing well. He's got pretty much everything nailed, I think. He's a bit more innovative than the other covers so far. They got the loincloths, kind of like Manowar type clothing. It's like a video. Swords and shit. It's a bit black metal-y. It's got something against the cactuses here. This is like a band, right? Black metal. It's smoking a peace pipe. I like my version better. This guitar song is quite difficult to play. Because of that stretch, it's which I put the capo on the second fret. It's correct. She knows how to play the song, note by note, I think. That's good. I like those kind of chilled out versions of our songs. I mean, this is a chill song to begin with, but it's even more chill here. Nice. Sorceress 2, piano version. I can't even remember my own song here. Did I write that? That was nice. Superb. Really nice. It feels like once somebody does a cover, especially if they move it onto the piano and they know what they're doing, it makes me sound like I actually know what I'm doing when I wrote the song. I think I get more impressed by piano plays because I can't really play the piano myself. Stole this from ABBA. Sounds almost exactly like the original. That's a singer preparing himself. I always write these overlong intros. I'm sorry. It's nice. Pretty close to the original. More innovative with the... I usually wear aviators, but not that shit. Bird. A papagoya. I can foresee that the vocals are going to be much louder than the music here. I get the parrot stereo. I keep looking around. I take it she's going to sing. We still have another minute or two before she starts singing. Jesus. I'm lost for words. Her voice is deep, but there's a parrot, and it's a bit weird. It's got a $1,300 guitar. It was recorded on a $2 guitar, pretty much. Again, a super long intro. Are they gonna sing? I love these guys, but I think that the shop owners probably don't like them as much. It's like a 10-minute song, holding up the test booth. So they must have planned this and practiced back home, but won't record it. They need Taylor guitars. And we sound like Mr. Big or something all of a sudden, like Poison. That's fun, though. Who comes up with these ideas? No. Sounds happy. Happy music is forbidden. Oh, I can't listen to this. It's good, but fucking hell. This is off of the Damnation record. But I think he's done another cover of ours. I wonder why he picked that song. I'll have to ask. I know him a little. It's a tricky part to see if he manages this part with the vocals. I always sing out of tune, fuck it up. He kind of eases back on the guitar, which is what I do too. I don't even play guitar and sing that, I just sing this part. That's nice, good work, Matt. The younger version of me is Peter. What is this? Looks, sounds like it's 10 people in the crowd. Oh man. What did he say? Play some metal? I mean, this is 23 years ago. Is that correct? Yeah, 23 years ago. That's the old, the first lineup. I can't watch myself, I'm fucking young, spotty kid. Well, I'm done. Interesting, some good stuff in there. Some interesting stuff in there and some extra interesting parrot sounds. Enjoy that. I might go search for more covers of my own music in the future. That was fun. And thank you for doing that for me. Thank you.